Hi friends, my name is Aruna. Today I will be making a soap with the tall and skinny shimmy technique for April's Soap Challenge Club. Soap Challenge Club is run by Amy Warden, and this month's challenge has been taught by Tatiana Serko of Creative Soap by Stesso. The tall and skinny shimmy technique is done by alternating pores of soap from either side of a tall and skinny mold. Each segment can be in a different contrasting color. To do this technique, the soap batter has to be really fluid, not very fluid that it blends into each other, and not thick, because each pore needs to push the batter a little to give the shimmy curves in between. So to help control the thickness of the batter, I decided to do away with the stick blender this time, and I plan to just use a hand whisk. I blended the batter by hand for at least 4 to 5 minutes, but don't worry, I will speed up this process so you don't have to watch me whisking the batter for 4 minutes. I plan to whisk the batter only until emulsion and not until thin trace, because by the time I add the color and the fragrance and blend it in, it's going to be a thin trace and perfectly suitable for the pore. I'm checking for emulsion on the spatula. If the batter splits and starts separating, then it's not emulsified yet, which is what I see right now. So it needs some more blending. The batter looks like it's emulsified quite well now, so it's time to prepare the colors. I have micas mixed with a little oil that I had saved from the recipe beforehand. The reason I disperse it in oil is so that I don't have to stick blend it or blend it too much and risk accelerating the trace at this point. The three colors that I'm using are soft pink, white satin, and orange yellow. The fragrance that I'm using is Frangipani. Frangipani flower color palette is what inspired the color choices of this soap. And here is a bit of boring math showing the calculations of each color and each segment. Take a look at this before we get into the interesting part of the pore. The batter has been divided among the three colors as close as possible to my calculations, and I have mixed the colors in. Now we are ready to start the pour, and I'm setting up the mold. The mold needs to be tilted a bit on either side when we pour it, and since I'm right-handed, I'm comfortable pouring only with my right hand. I did try with my left hand a couple of times and I made a big mess. So in this soap, all the pores will be with my right hand. I'm going to be using these little cups for each pore. So I am dividing the batter according to my calculations per segment. So each color in each segment has to be around 30 grams. Thank you. these little cups are probably not the best pourers, but I did not have any paper cups and I hate using single-use plastic. These are little food containers which I have clean sterilized, and I'm using it for the soap design this time. The rules for the advanced category stated that each segment needs to have at least 3 pores, and there should be exactly 7 segments in the entire soap. So I have 3 colors here, which I will be pouring in equal quantities from either side. So in between each pour, I need to measure the soap for the next segment. It's very critical that the soap batter remains fluid throughout this process. The fragrance oil that we use needs to be very CP stable, and the trays should not be too thick that it accelerates and goes on thickening as we complete the pour. The shapes of each of these segments will not have a good shimmy if the soap batter thickens up too much. I continue the pours on alternating sides of the mold, and I will speed up this video until I complete the entire process. I'll use up some of the remaining batter to quickly decorate the tops. Thank you. Here we are the next day to unmold and cut the soap. It was still quite early and the soap was soft, but I froze it for a couple of hours so that it comes out of the mold neatly. And here's the design. I'm quite pleased with the outcome and I hope to use this technique in a lot more of my soaps. Please enjoy a few of the pictures of this soap at the end of this video. Let me know in the comments what you think of my work and please subscribe, like, and share my YouTube channel. Thank you so much.